larger than a T-Rex and able to catch fish the size of bison. This ferocious predator from the Cretaceous is one of the most mysterious and controversial dinosaurs to ever live. Its secrets are only starting to be uncovered. This is the Spinosaurus. Hi, I'm Danielle Dufault, and you're watching Paleologic. Today, we're delving into dangerous Cretaceous waters and discussing one of the biggest bones of contention in the dino world. What did Spinosaurus look like? Before we jump into more about the Spinosaurus, I want to quickly talk to you about what I've been up to. Summertime always brings travel adventures that involve new people, new places, and new experiences. This summer, I decided to make the most of my upcoming trip by learning the local language with Babbel. Babbel teaches real-world, practical conversations, and it fits my schedule perfectly with short, 10-minute interactive lessons. There's multiple ways for me to learn, and it's scientifically proven to get me speaking the language in just 3 weeks. Check this out. Mira nuestro nuevo canal de Snapchat, Animalogic en Español. Babbel can be used to learn a new language for work, travel, or simply self-improvement. Click the link in the description to get 65% off your subscription. If you find the time isn't right to learn a new language, there's a 20-day money-back guarantee. Make the most out of your upcoming trip with Babbel. The story of Spinosaurus starts in 1915, when a German paleontologist named Ernst Stromer discovered the known fossils of a theropod with 1.6 meter long and very narrow lower jaws and long spines coming out of its backbone. Wanting to be as descriptive as possible, he named it Spinosaurus and sent the fossils to the Bavarian State Collection of Paleontology in Munich, where it was estimated to be about 97 million years old. But during World War II, the fossils were destroyed during a bombing of the city. For decades, illustrations of these few bones were all we had. So Spinosaurus was imagined as a 16-meter-long T-Rex with a croc-like face and a backsail. Basically the coolest dino of all time. This was the last time that we had a unified vision of this dino, and everyone was happy. But then, we started finding more fossils, and the paleo community started breaking into factions. In the 1980s, a new, similar species was discovered. It was called the Baryonyx. It had huge claws and showed that these were part of a family of dinosaurs, which was then named the Spinosauridae. These related species helped scientists piece together what Spinos would have looked like a little better and cemented their place as one of the largest theropods ever known. The long snout suggested a fish-heavy diet, and the huge claws would have helped it grab prey close to the shore. Fortunately, or maybe unfortunately, we kept finding fossils, which contradicted our early perceptions of Spinos. It's like reading a book in reverse and understanding less and less as the pages turn. First of all, their hind legs were revealed to be extremely short compared to other theropods, like T-Rex. They would make Spinos awkward and slow walkers, but might have been an adaptation for life in the water. They could have helped it swim like a crocodilian, and since they already had a croc-like face and likely ate fish, it would have made sense to spend more time in the water than other dinos. The bones were also more dense than in other theropods, which in other animals is used for buoyancy control. This is a bigger deal than it sounds like. Up until this point, there had been no indications of aquatic dinosaurs. Other aquatic creatures of the time, like plesiosaurs and mosasaurs, are technically not dinosaurs. It was weird. And then, tail vertebrae were discovered.
The tail was revealed to be long, narrow, and flat, like the tail of an axolotl, which would have helped Spinosaurus propel itself in the water. Long and strong toe bones, similar to those found in modern shorebirds, suggested that they have the ability to walk in muddy or silty soil. They could have even been webbed, but unfortunately, we have no evidence of that. There is also evidence that they had pressure receptors along the snout, much like crocodilians. And then, the discovery of a large number of teeth in river environments suggested that they could have spent a lot of time, maybe all of their time, in the water. Of course, that would have been way too easy a conclusion for this debate. Evidence for a more land-based lifestyle also started mounting. Body reconstruction suggested it couldn't really stand upright in the water without tipping over, unless it was moving forward. The tail also seemed too weak to be used for propulsion as effectively as a crocodilian does. It also would have been too massive and awkward a swimmer to pursue prey underwater. The sail and tail may not have been for balance and propulsion respectively, but rather a display for sexual selection, like a peacock's tail. Or it could have been a structure for a thermoregulatory organ, like elephant ears, or maybe even fat deposits, like a bison's hump. So depending on how you see it, it could have been an aquatic predator behaviorally similar to a croc, or a wading predator like a grizzly bear, who specialized in fish but could venture to land and eat carrion or catch prey opportunistically. The whole issue is complicated by the fact that only 6 specimens have ever been found, and they've all been incomplete and of different ages and sizes. Making an accurate model has been difficult. Kind of like trying to solve a 1,000-piece jigsaw puzzle, but you only have 6 pieces. Every sail vertebra ever found is broken, and we don't know how long they were, or if they created an arc or an M-shaped structure, or what its purpose was. We don't even know how powerful and propulsive the tail was. We don't know if when it walked on land, it moved like a bear with the ability to stand on its hind legs, or more like a pangolin, using its tail to balance while walking on 2 feet. We don't know how good of a swimmer it was, but we do know that it liked to eat fish and spend a lot of time near the water fishing. We know it was huge, and more importantly, that it was one of the coolest animals to ever live. So please, if you're out looking for fossils in the deserts of northern Africa, we need you to help us get closer to solving this puzzle. Until we do, it will continue to cause fights on paleo subreddits, provoke academic beefs, and break families of paleontologists apart. So what do you think it looked like based on the evidence? My favorite thing about it is that there's still so much room for interpretation. Please let us know in the comments and be sure to subscribe for new episodes every week. Thanks for watching. See ya!